Greetings students, in today's lecture we will be seeing about the brief history of implantable hearing aids. The history of implantable hearing aids dates back to the period of tympanoplasty. During tympanoplasty, the anatomical structures of the middle ear may get altered. The auricular chain or a part of the auricle may be removed during the surgery. This results in the reduction of the sound from the external ear conducted to the inner ear. To overcome this, a prosthesis will be implanted in the middle ear space. So that is the initial part of the implantable hearing aids. Those are called as passive implantable devices. Now we will see about the advancements happened in the implantable hearing aids. In the year 1935, Wilska placed iron particles on the eardrum and set these iron particles into vibration with the help of a magnetic field. Depending upon the change in the magnetic field, the iron particles started to vibrate, vibrating the tympanic membrane, and the natural physiological process of sound conduction took place. So this is a primitive experiment done in the year 1935. In 1959, Rushman fixed a 10 mg magnet at the umbo region of the tympanic membrane. This magnet was set into vibration by an electromagnetic coil placed in the ear canal. The sound waves were picked up by the microphone, amplified by the amplifier, and this amplified electrical energy was sent to the electromagnetic induction coil. This electromagnetic induction coil created magnetic fields. This magnetic field will make the magnet to vibrate, and the natural physiological process takes this vibration to the inner ear. Fredrickson et al. 1973 developed the first mechanical implant, which was implanted in the middle ear space. The transducer had a magnet implanted at the head of stapes. So since 1970s, the actual middle ear implant came into existence. Yanagihara was the first one to actually provide good results with the middle ear implants. He pioneered the technique of piezoelectric crystals. Piezoelectric crystals have a unique ability of vibrating whenever an electrical energy is being applied onto it, or whenever a vibrating energy is applied onto the piezoelectric crystal, it generates electrical energy. So when an electrical energy is being applied onto the crystal, they either condense or expand. When two pieces of piezoelectric crystal of different signs, so a positive piezoelectric crystal and a negative piezoelectric crystal, when they are bound together, they are called as bimorph. When an electrical energy is applied onto this bimorph, they start to vibrate. This technology was used to develop a middle ear implant by Yanagihara. So it consists of an external device and an internal device similar to that of the current cochlear implants. So the external device consists of battery, amplifier, microphone, and the external link coil. The sound will be picked up by the microphone, amplified, and sent to the external link coil. The internal link coil will receive this electrical information and pass this electrical information to the piezoelectric bimorph. So when an electrical energy is applied onto the bimorph, it starts to vibrate, and these vibrations will be sent into the inner ear. In 1987, based upon the principle of osseointegration. Osseointegration means the bone and the implant gets integrated into a single unit. Depending upon this principle, the bone anchored hearing aid and bone conduction implants were developed. In 1988, Haid et al. Advanced the electromagnetic middle ear implant by positioning an induction coil in the ear canal and magnet at any part of the auricle. In 1995, Maniglia et al. Placed magnets of 0.5 to 1 mm at the incus. This position led to a hearing improvement of 22 dB in cats. Followed this, they did human trials in the year 1996. So the sound from the external environment was picked up by the microphone placed in the ear canal, amplified by the amplifier, and sent to the induction coil. This induction coil created magnetic fields, which will be picked up by the magnet implanted at the incus. So the magnet starts to vibrate, incus vibrates, and the vibration will be sent into the inner ear. In 1995, Fredrickson et al. Worked in developing a middle ear transducer under the company Autologix. So they named it Autologix MET. This device had two components. External component has the microphone and the sound processor. The internal component will have a receiver coil, electrical circuits, and a middle ear transducer. This middle ear transducer is an electromechanical device. So the vibration happens at this transducer, and it will be this mechano-electrical transducer will be placed or implanted onto the incus. With the success of this kind of device, the microphone was again implanted inside the subject. So this Fredrickson's Autologix MET paved way for totally implantable hearing aids. Whereas at this particular time, 1995, it is partially implantable hearing aid, which means a part of the hearing aid will be visible externally and the other part will be implanted inside. In the year 1996, Ball developed an equipment called as Vibrant Sound Bridge. It was initially developed by Siemens company under the name Symphonic Sound Bridge. It also used electromechanical transducer, and later Medal company took it over in the year 2003 as Vibrant Sound Bridge. Here it is a partially implantable hearing aids. There will be an external audio processor consisting of the microphone, amplifier and a sound processor, and the internal device consists of the internal receiver, a conductor link and the floating mass transducer. This floating mass transducer can be placed at any part of the middle ear. So depending upon the incoming change in the electrical energy, this floating mass transducer starts to vibrate. In the year 1998, Lazifer and Zenner created the first fully implantable hearing system. It was called as TICA LZ3001. TICA stands for Totally Implantable Cochlear Amplifier. It can also be called as Totally Implantable Communication Aid. It is totally implantable in such a way that the microphone is again implanted in the ear canal. It is the processor and middle ear transducer implanted to the incus. So whole set, the receiver as well as the driver, all are totally implanted. In the year 2001, Hogue et al. Improved the version of Haidt's electromagnetic device. So here the transducer incorporated a magnet implanted at the incluse stapedial joint, whereas the processor was either in the ear or in the canal device, which will occlude the ear canal. So in the canal hearing aid will have the microphone, amplifier and an induction coil. This will be the external device, and the internal device will be magnet placed on the incluse stapedial joint. It's incus and stapes. In the incluse stapedial joint, a magnet will be placed. Depending upon the incoming sound, magnetic waves will be generated by the induction coil, and this will make the magnet to vibrate. Envoy Medical Corporation developed a totally implantable piezoelectric device named Envoy System. Later it came to know as Envoy Esteem. So piezoelectric device, here it is totally implantable in such a way that it uses the natural vibration of tympanic membrane as the microphone. Piezoelectric crystal had a specific or unique characteristic feature that whenever a vibration is applied onto the piezoelectric crystal, it generates electrical energy. Whenever electrical energy is being delivered onto the piezoelectric crystal, it starts to vibrate. So this particular system has two piezoelectric crystals. One acts as a microphone, the other acts as a driver. Depending upon the vibrations perceived by the tympanic membrane, these vibrations will be taken to the microphone or the receiver. So these vibrations will be converted to electrical energy, sent to the processor where it gets amplified and other processing takes place. Then that amplified signal will be, electrical energy will be sent to the driver. Depending upon this electrical energy, the piezoelectric crystal over here will start to vibrate, and that vibratory energy is sent into the stapes and into the inner ear. So it is completely or totally implantable hearing solution. So this is the history. history of implantable hearing aids, and the reference taken for this particular lecture is from Gauri Mankekar's Implantable Hearing Devices Other Than Cochlear Implants and from Valentine's Strategy for Selecting and Verifying Hearing Aid Fittings, chapter number 11. Thank you.